Hi, my name is Emily, and in this series of videos, we'll be going through how to perform web scraping using Perl. Now, web scraping is a pretty important skill because a lot of the data that we may want is freely available to us via the internet. However, to use something like Perl to automate the information retrieval and processing, we need to put it into a format that Perl can understand. And we know Perl is really good at working with strings. So how do we get a web page into some sort of string that Perl can use? And that's what we're going to be exploring in this series of videos. And to motivate that example, we'll use kind of a real life situation. So let's say you're in your enrollment period. However, you missed your enrollment appointment by a few weeks, and now a lot of the classes are really full. So what you want to know is, how full are the classes that I want to take? And to do that, we can create a program called Util Scraper, and given the course codes, we can actually scrape and see how full each lecture stream is. And the data is going to be from this Class Util website. So for those of you who are not familiar, the Class Util website can be found at classutil.unsw.edu.au, and it organizes by subject area how free the classes are. So let's say we clicked into comp, and let's just say we only want semester two information. We can go in, it lists the subject areas in a little table, and afterwards we get a class by class breakdown of how free the lectures, the tut labs, and everything is. So if we wanted to just see how full the lectures are, we need to look at this column with the percent full, and we only want to match it with ones that say lecture. So that's a pretty important first step when you're faced with a web scraping problem. You want to investigate the website, see what information you can grab, and kind of get an idea of where you want to be going with your programming. So I know that when I'm scraping my website, I want to look for this percent full. I want to match it with lectures, not tut labs. And another thing I want to notice is that the URL also changes. So the URL is usually classutil.unsw.edu.au, except now when we click into a website, it has the subject code and then an underscore s2.html. If we test it with a few other subject areas, so over here for the Chen subject area, we have underscore s2.html. So we can kind of see a pattern starting to emerge. Biotechnology, they also have the biot subject area, and then the same suffix underscore s2.html. So I know if I want to get to this website, given a course code, I can just extract the subject code, and that's going to be the URL. So it's very easy to build that URL up. Now that we've finished step one, investigating the website, we can start coding up the shell of the program. So let's open up our terminal, and we will open up a utilscraper.pl and our editor of choice. Let's start with the usual hashbane userbin perl wline. And from there, we know that it's really easy to make bugs when scripting. So let's just code things one by one. Looking back at our prompt, we want to accept at least one command line argument. Our program makes zero sense if we aren't given a course code to match. So we should specify that we need at least one command line argument. And if that's not the case, we can just crash the program so that the user knows how to use the program properly. So we want to put a helpful message over there. So this is how you use the program, and you expect at least one course code. That's what we should do. And let's just save and test that. Remember to make the script executable. And then let's try running it with zero command line arguments. We get the error message we expect. But now if we put in COMP2041, COMP1511, it doesn't give us any error messages. So far, so good. Next thing is, we know that we want to be performing the same action for every single course code. So for over here, if I specify multiple courses, I get psych 1011, and for each lecture stream, I do the same operations, same scraping operations. So that means I want to use a loop, a for each loop, and I want to get all of the course codes that are passed in as command line arguments, and we'll just call that course. So we'll loop through, but I also want to double check that this is a valid course code, because if you notice in our program, if I typed in, "Hi, my name is Emily," those command line arguments are going to pass through. So that's not too great. Let's double check that. So we want our course to start with four uppercase letters, followed by four digits. And that should be the only thing in that line. So if that's not the case, we also want to crash the program. Course is not a valid course code over here. So that's what we should try there. And if we succeed, let's just print out the course. Course is course. So let's print that out for sanity checking. Let's try that out. If I put in COMP2041, COMP1511, I expect that to pass. So yes, it's telling me course is course, and it's giving me the right subject codes. Now if I try, hi, my name is Emily, it should tell me hi is not a valid course code. So our safety checking is all done and good. And now the next thing we need to do is somehow we need to specify this URL that we need to get to. And we saw that to see the URL, we need to go to comp, and we need to find that subject code at the front of the course. So our course codes look like a subject code and then the numbers for the class. So we want to extract this subject code, and that can easily be done with regex. So with regex, we can just say subject, and we want to assign it to be just the first four capital letters over there of our course code. And we want to capture those capital letters and store it into subject. So we need to use the parentheses to say, I want to capture the four repetitions of capital letters over there. So that's our subject code over there. And again, just a sanity check. Let's print it out. Subject is subject over there. And we know that once we have the subject code, we can easily build up the URL because we said there was a common base, so classutil.unsw.edu.au, and then we had our subject code _s2.html. So there's a few hard-coded things I can have. I can have the classutil base, which is simply this URL over here. So that's the common base that all of our URLs have. They also have a common suffix, which is this _s2.html. So they all have that common suffix. And if I want to build up my URL, I can use string concatenation with a dot operator. So we know the first thing is that class util. So class util, use the dot operator. The next thing is this subject code that I've extracted using regex. So subject. And the last thing is that common suffix. So if that's the case, that should be our URL. And again, let's print it out just for sanity checking. So the URL is URL. Let's try that out. So with util scraper, if I have COMP2041, say psych1011, let's see what goes on. So the course is COMP2041, subject is comp, that's all good. And this URL does look same to me, same thing for psych. So if I put that into my web browser just to check, I do get the right web page that I'm looking for. So that's all good. So we have got into the website, we know which URL we want. How do we actually get that data? So right now we know which URL we want to get to, but in order to download that data, we have to use wget, which is a shell program, which lets us download the HTTP version of websites. So with this, we can specify a lot of options, but the only thing we want is this queue option, which turns off wget's output. Usually wget gives us some extra output that we don't care about. We only care about the HTML. The other one we need to specify is -o, which tells us where to output things to. But since we want Perl to read it, it makes sense to output it onto standard output, because then we can pipe that standard output into the Perl file handle. So we need that. And just to test that out, I use wget q capital O -- says I want to put the output file to standard output. And I need a URL to specify. So let's get the comp URL. We'll paste that here. And you'll see that the program just spits out the HTML onto your shell. However, it's not really too nice to view HTML in this format because there's no syntax highlighting or anything and you can't modify it anyway. So let's just also redirect it into a file called comp.html. And if we open it up over here, we can see that we have a version of it in Sublime. So it's a lot easier to read this and we'll need that later. But keeping that in mind, this is the very command that we need, wget qo. So to run an external shell program in Perl, we open it like it's a file handle. So we need open and we need a name for our file handle. Let's call it f. And we want to pipe standard output pipe it into the file handle. So that's how you use the dash and the pipe symbol. And on the right-hand side, if there's nothing there, that means pipe it into the file handle. And the command we want to run onto standard output is wget q dash o, as we have specified here, except now we don't want to hard code the URL. Let's use that variable we've been using over there. So that will open up the file, but you also want to check, did it open successfully? So let's use our or die idiom. So could not download URL over there. So that should be good. And the last thing we want to check is if we can open up the file, then we can read it line by line. So we can use a while loop and read from the file handle. And for now, just say, we'll print out the line. But let's first chomp the line to get rid of the trailing new line. That'll be useful later on. And then we'll print the line out over here. So that's our basic skeleton. You always want to test. So let's test that again. Yieldtoolscraper.pl. For COMP2041, I get that. And if I comment out this print statement over here, you'll see that I get the URL and I don't get any error messages. So that means it did download properly. And the same thing if I put in multiple course codes, it works fine. So I don't get any error messages. Everything seems fine. So looking back at this code, besides this debugging output, this is our basic skeleton for a web scraper. Now the only thing left to do is to fill out the web scraping logic over here. So we have converted our website into a format that Perl can very easily work through and understand. And from now on, it's just working with an array of strings, which you are very used to. So if you want to learn about how to actually scrape through the HTML to get the content you want, please watch my next video.